G'day students, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do subtraction with regrouping. So, here's a question which is a common sort of question for this operation. We have 54 and we're taking away 39. And we can see, and you'll remember that the 54 is made up of 5 tens and 4 ones. And the 39 is 3 tens and 9 ones. So I'm going to show you with some base 10 blocks, and then I'll show you how to do it with the written process. So here we have, now these are special magnetic base 10 blocks. So you may have base 10 blocks in your classroom, which your teacher may let you use for doing questions like this. These are just special magnetic ones for the teacher so we can stick them on the board. So I'll make a little bit more space. We'll always put the tens on the left-hand side because that's where they are when we write them down. Here are my ones. And you can see that's 54, 5 tens and 4 ones. Now, notice that when we're doing subtraction, we don't put out the second number as well, because this number we're going to be taking away from the 54. So from here, we'll take away 39. If we're doing addition, we would put both sets of numbers and then add them all together. And I'm sure you've done that already in your maths classes. All right, so 54 take away 39. Where are we going to start? Now, if we're just looking at the blocks, we could say, well, I could take away 3 straight away because that's my 3 tenths. But because of the way we do this in writing, we always start with the ones place or the ones column. So we're going to take away 9. Here are the ones. Can we take 9 away? And of course, the answer is no, because there are only 4 and 9 is bigger than 4. So where can we get some more ones from? Now, we're not allowed to take them from down here because this is the number we're starting with. So the only way we can do it is to do a swap or a trade of this 10 for some extra ones. Now, how many ones would this be worth? Of course, it's 10 ones. So I'll just move this down here and I'll put another 10 ones here. I'm going to put them in a long vertical strip like this. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2 more. So that it looks a bit like the 10 that was there before. I hope you can see this is the same lot of 10 that was there before. I've just changed them. We use other words for that. Sometimes we call it trading or regrouping or making and breaking 10. So I've really just broken a 10 and now I've made a whole lot more ones and I don't have so many 10s. So how many 10s do I have now? Well, obviously I have 4 tens. I did have 5, but now I've got 4. And how many ones do I have? I had 4 there before. They're still there. And now there's another 10. So that's actually 14 ones. Now, my question before we go any further is, what is that equal to? 4 tens and 14 ones is equal to what? Of course, the answer is 54. So we still have the same number. We've just rearranged some of the parts. Now we can do our takeaway. I'm sure you can see how easy it is now that we've done that trading or regrouping. And that was the most difficult part of the whole question. So now we're taking away 9. So it doesn't matter which 9 I take away. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. How many are left? Could you do that without counting? That would be something you could do in your head as a number fact. If we had 14, remember, and we're taking away 9, there will be 5 left. And now we're going to take away 3 tens. There we go. And of course, there's 1 ten left. There is our answer. What is the answer? The answer is 15. Let me show you with the written, what we call algorithm, the process that we use that you write down in your math book or on a whiteboard or a chalkboard or something like that. So we start again. I won't do all the blocks again, but you can remember what that looked like. We have 54 take away 39. We're going to start with the ones. We have 4 ones and we're taking away 9. Is that enough? No, it's not. 4 is too small to take 9, but we can regroup. We regroup from the 10. Remember, we took a 10 and broke it up into 1. So we'll cross out the tens because now we only have 4 tens left. So this number here will always be 1 less than that number. We take 1 of the tens and break it up. And what do we do with that 10? you'll remember we made it up into 10 ones. That 10 ones gets added to the 4 ones to make 14. So we write a little 1 there, and now you can see it says 14. As I said before, that's the hardest part of the question. Now it's a matter of recalling number facts and working out the answer. So 14 ones, take away 9 ones, of course that's 5 ones, and 4 tens take away 3 tens is 110. What's the answer? The answer is 15, and that's what that shows there. Okay, so now that you've seen that, you should be able to do some more of these on your own. The only thing that I would ask you to remember when you're doing these is when you first start, look and see whether you need to do regrouping, because not every question requires that you do that. Okay, that's it. And I'll talk to you next time.